Yellow paper with pumpkin. Investing in the middle school, allowing us to keep your kids here after school on circ equipment, and it always means a lot to me to have you guys be a part of this experience. When we talked about this, is the second year we've done this, in case you are new to Raving Gap in that way, and when we first talked about doing this last year, it was sort of a dream, and now we're sort of wanting to continue to have these conversations. And we talked about this year, Kathy Corey, our art teacher, brought up this idea of exploration, because we think that middle school is really the time to explore everything about who you are. So there's the idea of you as an individual, there's you in group dynamic, there's you in every facet of the world. That's why in a lot of ways with our arts programs, we require students to be in specific activities, even though sometimes that makes them feel a little uncomfortable outside of their comfort zone. So I say all of that to say tonight, in a lot of ways, is a celebration of all of that work. If you step out into the art spaces, what I think is so amazing for anything you'll see tonight is you'll have this mixture and collection of students who have never done art in the way that Ms. Corey asks them to do. You'll have students that have never performed on stage. They were just back there talking about how nervous they are. So in a lot of ways with Mr. McGrath, this is their first time stepping on a stage. And then for our musicians, there's this collection of, I love it, but it's these sixth grade kids that, right, this is the first time for a lot of them that they've ever put an instrument in their mouth. And so this is like 11 weeks of them learning an instrument. And then on the other hand, you have students that have been doing art either their entire lives or at least their entire short Raving Gap, that have acted, performed, have been on stage, been on circ apparatus. So, and then you have the same thing with our musicians, and you've got, you know, Roy Zhang, who has won awards and been an all-state performer. And to me, that is the beauty of what has always been middle school, and especially just middle school arts, is we are always a collection of all of those things, and in some ways we want to celebrate it. And so when we talked about this, when Tara and I first discussed the idea of having a middle school performance, it was because we wanted to be able to celebrate all of those things. That there will be times where we'll all giggle and laugh because they are still 10, 11, 12, 13 years old, and then there'll be times where we'll be wowed and amazed by the fact that how can a 10, 11, 12, 13 year old be doing what they're doing? So I want to thank you all for just being a part of that, and just I hope that you enjoy the show. We of course ask you to silence all of your devices. We prefer you not take a bunch of video and pictures. You know, don't yell when your kids get on stage. That's rude. I just learned that from, no, I knew that. I'm just gonna give it, right? We know you love your kids, and we want to love everybody. So I just want to say thank you again. Enjoy the show. We'll have a brief intermission, right? You'll see it in the program, but we'll have a brief intermission right before we get ourselves set up for our last circ number. But enjoy the show.
Romeo, bro. or if thou wilt, we have sworn my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet. His but thy name is my enemy. Thou art thyself, though not a Montague. What's a Montague? It is nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man. Oh, be some other name. What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other word would smell as sweet? Oh, Romeo would. Will he not Romeo call? Tame that dear perfection which he owes without that title. Romeo, doff thy name, and for thy name, 'tis no part of thee, take all myself.
But soft, what light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon, who's already sick and pale with grief, that thou her mate art far more fair than she. Be not her mate, since she's envious, her best delivery is but sick and green, and none but fools do wear it. Cast it off. It is my lady, oh, it is my love, but that she knew she were. She speaks, yet she says nothing.
Absolutely. Don't worry about your voice, getting every word perfect. Just read the scene the way Melissa would, okay?
Okay, I'll try. Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?
All right, I tell everyone, no phones.
I'm sorry, it's mine. I'll just... Okay, I'm ready now.
Melissa, was that your acting coach sending a text message?
No, it's my doctor. Doctor, it was my doctor. Thank you. I mean, thank you! Thank you!
Hey, thanks for coming.
Thank me. You. I mean you. Thank
you. Well, let's see what you got for our monologue.
Monologue?
What's a monologue? I mean monologue.
Hey, monologue. Great.
But soft. What light through the window? There. Romeo. I love you. We should kiss.
Thank you.
Corey Hager.
Meta Crossing, how are you? I'll let you know for herself. Can I have a moment to warm up?
No, although we do have other people coming in.
Thank you, but I can't even go to this one completely.
No, if you want, we can bring someone in.
Thank you, but no, I'll only be a minute.
Do you mind if I run
to you? No, she's a
job!
I was supposed to start rehearsing next week.
Hey, I'm just going to go ahead and give her the green light to know you're dealing with stuff and that.
Well, Sam, I'm being prejudiced. I'm not being prejudiced. Being to me, the actors went from incompetence to insane.
Good evening.
How are y'all today?
This is the sixth grade exploratory arts class, and we've been playing for about 6 weeks on these instruments. Typically in a public school setting, we would be working from like September to Christmas, and that would be the first concert. So I think I counted up about 24 hours is all we played in class. So they were doing a great job. And so we're just going to play a couple little ditties for you, and we hope you enjoy them. The first one is, of course, is an audience favorite, Hot Cross Buns.
Thank you.
about five notes, and now this new one we're going to do, we're going to go to six notes. Okay, so this is going to be Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, or if you prefer, the ABC song. Okay. It's just still the first five notes, but it has eight notes. And any of y'all watch Big Bang Theory? Nell Sopke? I wanted to do something different, so I wrote it for him. So here we go, Sopke.
Have my
time at your disposal. It shall be either to this man or to her death. According to our law, immediately provided in that case.
What say you, Hermia? For you, the gift of God. Demetrius is a worthy gentleman.
So is not saying.
But in this kind, watching your father's voice, the other must become the worthier.
I beseech your grace that I may know the worst that may befall me in this case if I refuse to wed Demetrius.
Either to die the death, or to forever abjure the society of men. For I, to live in a shady, moister community, to live a barren sister all your life.
So I will grow, so live, so die, my lord.
Take time to pause, and by the next new moon, the sealing day betwixt my love and me, and the everlasting bond of fellowship. Upon that day I am prepared to die for disobedience to your father's will, or else wed Demetrius, as he would, or on Diana's altar protest for high austerity and single love.
Really, sweet Hermia, and Lysander, yield that crazy title to my switching right. You have her father's love, Demetrius. Let me have Hermia's. Do you marry him? How now, my love? Why is your cheek so pale? How chance the roses there do fade so fast?
Do you like for want of rain, which I could well wear for the tempest of mine eyes?
I me, for aught that I could ever read, could ever hear by tale or history, the course of true love never did run smooth.
Oh, how? To choose love by another's eyes?
Hear me, Hermia. I have a widow aunt, a dowager of great revenue, and she hath no child. From Athens remote is her house 7 leagues, and she respects me as her only son. Fair gentle Hermia, may I marry thee, and to that place the sharp Athenian law cannot pursue us. If thou lovest me, then, steal forth thy father's house tomorrow night, and in the wood, a league without the town, where I did meet thee once with Helena, to do observance to a morn of May, there will I stay for thee.
My good Lysander, I swear to thee by Cupid's strongest bow, by his best arrow for golden head, in that same place thou hast appointed me, tomorrow truly will I live with thee.
Keep promise, love.
That's all. You shall play in your mask when we speak as small as you will.
not the joiner?
You the lion's heart. Have you the lion's heart written? Pray you with me. Give it to me, for I so study.
You may do it exemplary, for it is nothing but roaring.
Let me be the lion's part. I roar well. If any man's part, good to hear me.
And you would frighten the Duchess in all the ladies.
That would hang us as another son.
I would worship as any dove. I would roar as any knight in the air.
You can play no part for Pyramus.
Well, I will. Masters? Hear your parts. I am to entreat you, request you, and desire you to crown them by tomorrow night, and meet me in the palace wood a mile without the town. For there you will rehearse. For when you meet in the city, we shall be doffed with company our devices know. In the meantime, I will draw both properties as our play wants. I pray you, fail me not.
We will meet, and there we may rehearse most obscenely and courageously.
At the Duke's own take.
Instrumental ensemble. So we're going to play a couple tunes for you. First thing we're going to do is going to be a Bach chorale. The next piece we're going to do is I don't know if anybody knows this movie anymore. It's It's the king from the big ice castles.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye. Thank you. sky that's flying with nowhere to be. Don't know you super well, but I think that you might be the same as me. Behave abnormally. Let's let things come out of the woodwork. I give you my best, I tell you my best lies. Yeah, awesome, right? So let's let things come out of the woodwork. I give you my best, I tell you my best lies. Tell you my best lies.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Mm-hmm.